Welcome back to Fox 2 News. You are watching continuing coverage of breaking news in Ferguson tonight. There is a lot of looting going on, and now we are at yet another location that is being looted as we speak. Bobby Hughes in the Mazda Roadrunner is on scene, and he joins us now with what's happening. Bobby?
That's right, guys. Yeah, I was just at the sporting goods store, and then look behind me in the shopping center. There's at least three more stores being looted at this point. We're seeing a lot of windows being smashed, people running out with clothing. I have noticed that a lot of these vehicles that are involved in this, a lot of the tags have been removed from those cars as these looters continue to go through these stores and carry out everything they can carry. Several clothing stores here, a tennis shoe store, a mobile store, people running out with armloads of clothing, throwing it into any kind of car that's waiting on them. So no police presence in this area. They were just here just a few moments ago and left and went to another area, but people continue to loot along here, Lucas and Hunt and West Florissant.
Yeah, Bobby, is it a huge crowd of people? Because I can see several individuals coming out of a business right now. That looks like some sort of an electronics, no, clothing store looks like that young man is coming out of the store with an arm full of clothing.
That's right. Yeah, it's DTLRs, the store. It has those security chains on the front window, but all of a sudden everybody's run out to the car and has taken off from this area. I had one individual drive up and tell me, he said, this makes no sense at all. Why are our people doing this? And that's been the case up here this morning, is a lot of people just frowning on what's happening to some of the businesses that serve this area in North County.
Right. And then I'm wondering, Bobby, can you hear any alarms or any of the security alarms going off?
Only in a couple places have I heard alarms. I've been to several auto supply places where the alarm's been sounding, and just a roving motorcade of police cars. They were here just a few minutes ago at the sporting goods store. Just as soon as they pulled off the parking lot, headed to another location, another swarm of cars pulled up, and they continued looting the sporting goods store. So police have their hands full. I know they've got the helicopter up, and it's trying to spot these masses of cars that are moving around in these shopping centers stealing these goods. But there's a shopping safe here that appears to be closed. The Home Depot is closed, but it looks like maybe some of their personnel are kind of standing guard in the parking lot. But right now, it's just it's vacant here. Everything you saw just a moment ago is cleared off as these looters move on, perhaps to another location. Charlie?
It is interesting that you mentioned that there are some personnel from some of the businesses that are standing by.
That's right. Yeah, I've seen some individuals in cars as they kind of patrol the areas where their business is located. Unfortunately, we hope there's no serious injuries, and someone may be trying to protect their business here this morning, but police are doing all they can to try to patrol these parking lots. I just had a van pass in front of me, a minivan with probably seven or eight young males, all with scarves on their faces. So that's the problem we're dealing with, is the roving bands of looters here that know that they are ahead of the police on these locations, and just running from one store to another, one shopping center to another. And we are definitely north of the situation down on West Florissant. We're actually at 270 and Hall Ferry Road, so the looting seems to be just kind of scattering all to the north of here now.
So that area where you are now, Bobby, is that no longer Ferguson?
It's, I would say I've seen some Ferguson police cars up here. I've seen St. Louis County police cars, but I do believe I'm still in the city limits of Ferguson.
Yeah.
And we're watching now as like a secondary group of cars comes up. They seem to be kind of following behind the first group, and they'll run in and grab what they can. I don't know if these individuals are communicating with each other with cell phones, telling what stores have been broken into and what's not being patrolled, but just lots of cars in these shopping centers. And we're going to stay here for a moment and see if we get a secondary band of looters that run into these stores here. I've counted in the last minute or so, at least seven or eight, nine cars that have pulled up here, casing out the joint to see if and there are any police officers on the scene, and perhaps they're going to make a run and try to grab some more merchandise from these stores here that have been broken into.
Yeah, I think it's interesting, Bobby, that you pointed out that some of these individuals may be on their cell phones and calling up friends, perhaps, to come to these specific locations.
That's right, Shirley. We know that police have been in this area. They're probably... I hear you, sir. I just had an individual pull up and tell me that he's really ashamed of what's going on up here this morning.
Yeah, I'm sure a lot of people are. Bobby Hughes on location. Thank you so much. I appreciate it.